My name is Julia Stal, and I am a recent graduate from the PhD in Health Behavior Research. So I did a psychology undergraduate degree, and I tailored my coursework to focus on health psychology, and I conducted health-related research as an undergraduate. I was really interested in just health outcomes and improving quality of life for individuals. I didn't quite know what that would look like long-term at that stage, but I was involved in a number of different activities related to health and public health specifically. And then ultimately, I sort of refined that interest to focus on chronic illness, and I was involved in cancer-related research as well. And then when I applied to the PhD in health behavior research, I was really interested in strictly conducting cancer research, and that became my area of focus. And then over time in the program here, I refined that interest even more. So now I focus on pediatric, adolescent, and young adult cancer survivorship. I work on medical outcomes after cancer or late effects. I also work on disparities, quality cancer care delivery, and reproductive health after cancer. And really all of those interests were developed again over time. But the data suggest that these are areas that are really neglected and are important for our patients. And as public health professionals, it's our duty to go where we are needed and where the patients need us. And so really the data and the patients have, more than anything, I think, sparked my interest and helped me refine as I've moved along my career. I chose to pursue an advanced degree because I loved the research I was doing as an undergraduate, and I knew I wanted to do it long term. My ultimate goal is to become a PI or principal investigator, and I really wanted to run my own lab and get to design studies and work with patients and kind of be the ringleader of all of the research that was ongoing, and also get to develop really cool studies as well. And I needed a PhD to get to do that. And so the decision to pursue the degree was really informed by the ultimate job that I wanted at the end of my education. I chose USC because I was really excited about my advisor. I have worked with Dr. Kim Miller for the past 5 years. She has just been an excellent tour guide and led me through this experience that is a doctorate degree. And I think picking an advisor is one of the most important decisions you'll make in your PhD. And I just had a really good feeling about her and the research environment that I would be working with. And so that was a big contributor to me choosing USC. I also was very excited about coming to USC because of the geographic region. We're in Los Angeles. We have a large, diverse community, especially a large, diverse community of patients here, various languages, backgrounds, and getting to kind of be exposed to and have experience to a diverse network of patients is really valuable and important, not just for my development as a researcher, but to ensure that my outcomes are generalizable and are actually impacting the patient population that I'm interested in impacting. And one more reason why I chose USC was because the degree in health behavior research felt like it opened a number of doors so I could run my own lab, I could become a research scientist, work for the government in a health-related position, go into policy work, and really just kind of spread my wings in terms of what I could do in health-related research and in public health in general. And that was a very appealing aspect of the program for me. As part of the fertility-related work that I've been a part of during my PhD, I've learned that fertility is really a prominent unmet need for our young patients, and it's really important to them. So because of this, clinical practice organizations have developed guidelines that are intended to facilitate the delivery of comprehensive oncofertility care. However, a prominent gap in the literature exists here, where we know these guidelines exist, but we really don't know how they are or are not integrated in practice. So the study that I developed sought to really understand barriers to the integration of these guidelines in practice, and ultimately to inform future interventions to ideally improve health outcomes for patients and quality care delivery related to oncofertility. Another exciting project that I got to be a part of during my PhD was with the American College of Surgeons Commission on Cancer, or ACS. And the ACS accredits institutions that provide quality cancer care in accordance with a number of standards that they have across the United States. So over 70% of cancer patients in the US are seen in ACS accredited institutions. And this project was really exciting because we cataloged the availability of cancer survivorship services on a national level. So from this study, we now know what is the availability of services across different cancer settings, different states, different institutions, and it really gives us sort of a benchmark understanding of what is and is not available for patients. One of my most memorable experiences at USC was being awarded the National Cancer Institute's F99K00 Predoctoral to Postdoctoral Transition Award. And this grant was really exciting because it funded the remainder of my PhD and also gave me tremendous flexibility when searching for a postdoctoral position. It gave me protected time to focus on my training and research that I developed during my PhD, and it allows me to extend my doctoral training into my postgraduate training and really set myself up for a solid career as an independent investigator. The advice I have for students embarking on a PhD is to really remember your why and hone in on this throughout your journey. It's a marathon, not a sprint, and you really want to get the most out of this experience. I also really recommend nurturing the relationship with your advisor. Your advisor is arguably the most important person that you will meet throughout your training, and they will carry you through to the next stage of your career and potentially beyond. And so that's really a relationship that you want to nurture. I also just encourage students to really take advantage of all of the resources available to them. Immerse yourself in as many experiences and opportunities as you can and be a sponge to all of the information available to you. I attended conferences annually throughout my PhD, and they really were a great way for me to get to present my research, to meet other scholars and network, and really to learn about ongoing work and get reinvigorated about all of the exciting research to come. A very important faculty member throughout my time at USC is Dr. Kim Miller, who has been my primary advisor throughout the past 5 years. She has really exemplified all of the important qualities of a good mentor. She has been accessible, available, flexible, has provided constructive criticism, and really has led me through this journey. She has also helped connect me to a number of faculty members in the department that I had the pleasure of working with. So I got to work with Dr. Sue Kim on a study to understand barriers to timely colorectal cancer diagnosis in a safety net setting. Reflecting on my time at USC, I'm really proud of my academic journey and all of the experiences, opportunities, and networking that I've been able to be a part of, and really how the sum of all of these experiences have helped me transition to the next phase of my career. After graduation, I will be a postdoctoral research fellow at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute at Harvard, where I will be working on system and policy level factors to improve oncofertility care for young cancer patients.